Imagine if our bodies could heal like superheroes. What if we could instantly recover from injuries like a bullet wound or reverse a deep cut wound? Not only would our skin heal, but our tissues, muscles, and even bones could regenerate within hours or days. It sounds like a scene from a superhero movie, right? But what if I told you that nature already has some secrets for this kind of healing, and scientists are on the brink of unlocking them for us? Superhealing is already happening in the animal kingdom, and scientists are learning to harness it to fight one of our greatest enemies, cancer. Let me take you to the world of the axolotl, a salamander from Mexico. If an axolotl loses a limb, it doesn't panic, it regenerates it. The injured site forms a strange structure called a blastomer, a sort of biological blueprint for regeneration. These cells aren't like your regular cells. They reprogram themselves, reverting to a simpler state, like clay ready to be molded into new tissue. This is known as epimorphic regeneration, and it's not just limited to salamanders. Starfish can regrow entire arms, and even certain lizards can regrow their tails. These creatures have developed an astonishing ability to rebuild what's lost. But here's where it gets interesting. Humans have some of this ability too, just on a much smaller scale. Your liver, for instance, can regenerate after injury, though not to the fantastic degree we see in these animals. But what if we could change that? What if we could take the same principles behind epimorphic regeneration and apply them to humans? This is the question driving scientists forward. Now let's journey into the lab, where scientists are working tirelessly to unlock the secrets of superhealing for humans. You see, in the last decade, there have been some incredible breakthroughs. Take CRISPR-Cas9, for example. This tool is like a pair of molecular scissors, allowing scientists to cut and edit genes with remarkable precision. But it's not just for correcting genetic diseases. Researchers are experimenting with CRISPR to enhance regeneration. In one study, scientists targeted a gene called PAX7 in mice, a gene responsible for muscle repair. By activating this gene, the mice were able to regenerate muscle tissue far more quickly after injury. Imagine applying that to humans. Not just repairing muscles, but bones, nerves, and even organs. Another possibility for superhealing is hidden in telomeres, the protective caps at the ends of chromosomes, which play a critical role in cell division. In most human cells, telomeres shorten with each division, leading to aging and cellular death. However, in organisms like the immortal jellyfish, there is a process of reversing cell aging, mediated by the enzyme telomerase, which rebuilds telomeres. Some researchers suggest that activating telomerase could be a pathway to enhanced healing and even longevity. Researchers are also developing bioengineered scaffolds made from hydrogels infused with growth factors like transforming growth factor beta and bone morphogenetic proteins. These scaffolds can be implanted at injury sites to serve as a matrix that encourages cells to regenerate faster and more effectively. A study published in Advanced Functional Materials showed how these scaffolds could promote bone regeneration in cases where traditional treatments failed. Another mechanism is hypoxia-inducible factor. Hypoxia, or low oxygen conditions, can trigger a healing response in tissues by activating hypoxia-inducible factors. Drugs like dimethyl oxalyl glycine are being tested to artificially induce this hypoxic response, promoting vascularization and tissue repair. Imagine speeding up recovery from a heart attack by mimicking the body's natural healing response to injury. Another exciting frontier is stem cells. Stem cells are like the blank slates of the body, capable of turning into any kind of cell. Researchers are developing mesenchymal stem cells that can speed up the healing of wounds, delivering powerful growth factors like VGF and EGF, substances that encourage the growth of new blood vessels and skin. There's even talk of using exosomes, tiny packages that cells use to communicate, to supercharge healing. Think of these exosomes as the body's microscopic delivery service, bringing healing instructions directly to the injured tissue. But here's where the story takes a twist. Superhealing sounds amazing. Who wouldn't want the ability to regenerate tissues and recover faster? But like many things in biology, it comes with a dark side. The same mechanisms that allow cells to grow and regenerate can also fuel something dangerous: cancer. At its core, cancer is uncontrolled cell division, and the pathways that promote healing are sometimes hijacked by cancer cells. Take the mTOR pathway, for instance. This is a signaling pathway that promotes cell growth, metabolism, and survival. When activated, it can help tissues regenerate faster. But in cancer, this same pathway is overactivated, driving the rapid growth of tumors. That's why drugs like rapamycin, which inhibit the mTOR pathway, are used to slow down cancer cell growth. There's another biological process that links superhealing and cancer: epithelial mesenchymal transition, or EMT. EMT is essential for wound healing. It's the process that allows cells to migrate and repair tissues. But it's also how cancer cells invade other parts of the body, spreading the disease. So, as we learn to manipulate EMT to enhance healing, we have to be extremely careful not to accidentally encourage cancer cells to spread. The future of healing is not just about finding ways to regenerate our tissues. It's about walking a fine line. We've made incredible strides in developing therapies that harness the body's natural healing abilities. For instance, innovative cancer treatments like CAR T-cell therapy and PD-1 inhibitors not only fight cancer, but could also hold clues for tissue regeneration. By harnessing the immune system's power, these therapies might help clear senescent cells, old cells that don't divide but secrete harmful signals, thus enhancing regenerative processes. The challenge is avoiding autoimmunity and ensuring these approaches don't inadvertently support cancerous growths. Imagine if we could clear them out, allowing the body to heal like it did in our youth. Yet, we must proceed carefully. Gene therapy, stem cells, and growth factor modulation are incredibly powerful tools, but they can be dangerous if misused. The path to achieving superhealing is not just about biology and chemistry. It's also about ethics and careful consideration. Should we edit genes in embryos to enhance healing abilities? While this could prevent genetic diseases, it also raises ethical concerns about designer babies and unintended consequences in the gene pool. Advanced regenerative treatments could revolutionize medicine, but at what cost? Who will have access to such groundbreaking therapies? Ensuring equitable distribution and preventing misuse will be critical. The unregulated use of stem cells and growth factors has already led to dangerous outcomes in some unlicensed clinics. Establishing international standards and rigorous clinical trials will be necessary to ensure the safe application of these powerful tools. So here we are at the crossroads of science and possibility. In a nutshell, nature has already shown us the wonders of superhealing, from salamanders regrowing limbs to jellyfish reversing aging. And humans, we're not that far behind. From gene editing to stem cell therapy, we're on the verge of a revolution in medicine that could change how we heal, and perhaps even how we live. But as we look to the future, it's important to remember that with great power comes great responsibility. Can we harness superhealing without unintended consequences? Only time and science will tell.